Welcome to our YouTube channel, Nursing Beats. Well, today we start a new series of lectures of important topics in medical surgical nursing and relevant multiple choice questions and answers that can be asked in competitive examinations. So let's start with the central nervous system. In central nervous system, one of the important topic is GCS or Glasgow Coma Scale. So today we are going to learn about GCS. The GCS was introduced in 1974. It is the gold standard of neurologic assessment and it was invented by Graham Teasdale and Brian J. Janet. They were the professors of neurosurgery department at the University of Glasgow. Thus, this tool has got this name, Glasgow Coma Scale. First of all, we should know why GCS is that much important in central nervous system. It is because GCS is a powerful assessment tool which helps to assess the patient's level of consciousness easily and quickly. Purpose. Here mainly you should remember two points. First one, assess the level of consciousness of the patient quickly. It means when a patient comes in emergency department, it is important to assess the level of consciousness of the patient as early as possible. In this situation, the first choice we can use to get the baseline changes in consciousness is GCS. Because all other investigations will take time to give the result and it will endanger the life of the patient. The second purpose of GCS is it can be used to evaluate the prognosis or progress of a patient with a neurological deficit in a clinical setting. And that is when a patient is admitted in hospital or ICU setup with a severe neurological deficit, all the brain functions and consciousness may be altered. But after proper treatment, the condition can be improved. So by using regular GCS scale, we can check the progress of such patients. Now let's discuss the details of GCS. GCS has the scoring of 3 to 15. It means the minimum score is 3 and maximum is 15. The scoring has mainly three parameters. First one, eye opening response. Second one is verbal response. And third one is motor response. So let's see what is eye opening response. In eye opening response, we check the opening of eyes of the patients and thereby evaluate the level of consciousness. In these parameters, the maximum score is 4 and minimum score is 1. So the first one, E4, it means spontaneous eye opening. Here the patient will opening his eyes without any stimulus. It means that he is fully conscious and his arousal mechanism in the brainstem are intact. So this is maximum score, that is E4, which shows the normal consciousness of the patient. Next, second one is score 3 or E3. Here the parameter is eye opening response to verbal command. It means when a verbal stimulus is given, patient opens his eyes. It is not compulsory that we have to call the patient to give the verbal stimulus. It can be any loud sound which is enough to evoke response of the patient. So this is the second stage, score E3, in which patient opens his eyes. When we give a verbal command or stimulus, here the level of consciousness is not completely intact. And next is score E2. E2 means eye opening response to pain. Here a painful stimulus is given at either the nail bud with a pen or pencil or pinching the trapezius muscles like that. The stimulus should be sustained around 10 seconds before concluding the response. So if the patient is opening his eyes when we give a pinch or pain stimulus in any pain sensitive areas of the body, we can conclude score 2. Then the last minimum score is E1. E1 means there is no eye opening response. That is, if the patient does not open his eyes even after giving a painful stimulus, it means he is having the least score in eye opening and a low grade of consciousness also. This is first section, best eye opening response, which include four scores E4, open eye spontaneously, E3, open eyes to verbal command, E2, open eyes to pain, and E1, no eye opening response. The next parameter in Glasgow Coma Scale is verbal response. While assessing verbal response, the scoring is from 1 to 5. V5 oriented, V4 is confused, V3 inappropriate speech, V2 incomprehensive sound, and V1 no verbal response. V5 is oriented means the person is having normal level of consciousness. Here we ask the patient regarding name, where he is at current situation, and the date or day or time to check the person, place and time orientation. If he is able to give correct answer means he is oriented. Next, V4 is confused. In this case, the patient may be answering something, but it will not be the appropriate answer for the questions, or he may be confused to give answer. Then we can give a score of V4. In V3, patient may respond with some inappropriate words, but the words may not have any connections with each other. So we conclude V3 as inappropriate words. V2 is incomprehensible sounds. Here the patient cannot conversate, may not be able to give answer to questions. They can only produce some vague sounds, and especially the sound may be produced while giving painful stimulus. The last and minimum score is V1. Here no verbal response will be there. This is all about verbal responses. Before concluding verbal responses, one important point is that in certain conditions we cannot assess the verbal response accurately. For example, in intubated patients or patients with a tracheostomy, it's not possible to get a correct verbal response assessment. The last parameter in GCS is motor response. Here the maximum score is 6 and minimum score is 1. M6 means obeying commands. Here we ask the patient to move the limbs or fingers, and if they do well means motor response is good. M5 is localizing to painful stimulus. It means we give a painful stimulus to check whether the patient is able to localize the area where the pain stimulus is given. For example, we give a pinch in a trapezius muscle and the patient moves his hand to reach that area. Means he can sense the pain and exact location of the pain. M4 is normal flexion or withdrawing from pain. Means when we give a pinch, the patient suddenly withdraw that area or limb to avoid the pain. Next, M3 is abnormal flexion to pain. Here the limb in which pain stimulus is given, it will be abnormally flexed, means a decorticate posture will be there. The opposite response will be there in M2, where the limb will be extended or a decerebrate posture will be there. And the last and least score is M1, in which there will not be any motor response or movement of limbs even when the most painful stimulus is given. So this is about motor response. Let me conclude once more. M6 is obey commands, M5 localized to painful stimulus, M4 withdraw from pain, M3 flexion to pain stimulus, M2 extension to pain stimulus, and M1 is no more response to pain stimulus. So after checking all these parameters, we can calculate the total score to conclude about the level of consciousness of the patient. The total score is 15. While calculating the total score, if it is less than 3, patient will be in deep coma stage. The score 3 to 8 we can consider as coma. 9 to 14 includes mild to moderate brain injuries, and the highest score 15 denotes patient is normal and fully conscious and there is no neurological deficit. This is all about GCS, and it is a very important topic in the central nervous system, and hope everybody understood the topic. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, comment and support us. I will be back with another topic on my next video. Till then, bye from Shubhendu CP. Thank you.